Welcome to this new Consepsys Document Control Tip of the Month. This month, we show you 25 features that will make your life easier with Word. We've gathered 25 Word features that you probably wished you had known before. We've grouped them into four categories: formatting, find and replace, ergonomics, and editing. Tell us in the comments if some of these features are new to you or if you're super proficient with Word and know them all already. Let's start with formatting. Number one, Format Painter. An easy way to get productive in Word and to minimize the time spent formatting documents is to use the Format Painter. Let's say you want to make this paragraph look similar to the paragraph above. Just place your cursor on the text with the formatting you want to copy, then click on the Format Painter button, and next, click on the paragraph you want to reformat. It's now magically formatted in the same way as the model. If you click on the button once, then it will work only once on the next thing you will click on. If you click the button twice, this will make the Format Painter apply to everything you will click from now on. If you want to stop using the Format Painter, then press Escape. Number two, Reveal Formatting. Press Shift and F1, and it will display a panel on the right-hand side showing you the formatting used in the document. This comes in handy when you spot a formatting issue with your document but want to be sure of exactly what is wrong. Number three, Clear Formatting. When you press Ctrl and Space, this is really useful because it's gonna clear automatically the formatting of the text that you have selected. Number four, Change Default Pasting Options. You probably already know that when you copy and paste a piece of text, you have different options for pasting. For example, pasting the text only or keeping the original formatting. Depending on the situation, we often use one of these options most frequently. I find the text-only pasting most useful because that removes the format of the original text and gives me full control over the format that I will then apply to the piece of text I'm pasting. But because it's not the default mode in Word, it requires a few extra clicks every single time I paste something. To avoid those clicks, you can change the default pasting options by clicking on File, Options, Advanced, and then cut, copy, and paste. You have loads of options in there. Number five, Create Styles. You can use styles to quickly apply a set of formatting choices consistently throughout your document. Let's say you want all of your main headings to look like this one. Make sure you're happy with the original, and then right-click on the original style you want to copy. Then click on Styles, Create a Style. Give it a name and click on OK. Then select the text you want to format similarly and click on the Home ribbon on the style you created. From now on, if you change the style, it will automatically apply to all instances of this style. For example, let's say that I want to change the font color for this style. I will right-click on the style I want to change, click on Modify, and then change the formatting as needed. And when I press OK, the new style will be applied everywhere. Number six, Shrink One Page. This feature adjusts the font size and margins of the document's content to fit onto fewer pages. If you have a document of 3 pages and you want it to be 2 pages only, then you can use this feature so that it will quickly adjust all the formatting to make it 1 page less than what it currently is. Of course, you'll need to use this feature with caution if you have strict requirements in terms of formatting and styles, as Word will slightly amend the styles in order for the content to fit on one less page. Number seven, Change Case feature. Highlight any text and then click the Change Case button in the Home tab. You can change the case, for example, from all uppercase to sentence case. And you can do it in the other way around also. It's so much quicker, and if you've ever done this manually by retyping the text, this will probably change your life. Number eight, Show and Hide Formatting Symbols. This feature shows all the formatting plainly. This is useful when checking the formatting issues in a document. For example, if I don't understand why this document goes to the next page and leaves half a blank page here, I'll hit this button and it will reveal that there is a page break here that I did not know about. Then I'll easily remove it. When you click on Show the formatting symbols, it makes the document really, really busy and challenging to read. So when we don't use this feature, we can click on Hide. Number 9, change a numbered list. Sometimes when you have a numbered list in a document, you wish to change the numbers, but Word won't let you because it manages the numbers automatically. For example, let's say that on this list, I want to start again at 1 at this point, because it's a different list from the list above. I can do that by right-clicking the value I want to change and then clicking on Set Numbering Value. In there, I can tell Word if I'm starting a new list or not and which value I want to use from now on. This also comes in handy when you have numbered sections and subsections in Word. My next category is Find and Replace. The tip number 10, Advanced Find with Control F. You probably already use Ctrl F to find certain information in a document. For example, I'll use it now to find all instances of John Doe. But you have several options to make your search easier with the Advanced Finds. For example, you can make your search case sensitive. Let's say I'm looking for all instances where a certain name is missing its capital letter. Or you can find text formatted in a specific way by clicking on Format at the bottom of the Advanced Find window and then looking for words written in a specific color or specific font size, for example. Next tip is the tip number 11, Control H. The sister feature of the Find feature is the Find and Replace feature. Let's say I want to replace all instances of 2022 in the document with 2023. I'll press Ctrl H to open the Find and Replace feature. I'll put 2022 at the top in the Find What area and 2023 in the Replace With area. And then I can either press Replace to replace one by one, and that's probably better to make sure that I don't replace one instance by mistake, or I can press Replace All to replace all instances in one go. My next category is ergonomics. And I'll start with tip number 12, dark mode. If you work on office apps such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint all day, the default setting might be tiresome for your eyes. You can easily switch to a dark mode to give your eyes a break and use dark mode by default. Go to File, Account, Office Theme, Dark Gray. Number 13, Custom Ribbon Tabs. Microsoft Word has default ribbons at the top of the window that gives you access to the most frequent features, but these are not necessarily the most frequent ones for you. So you can customize the ribbon to show the features you need the most. To do this, click on the ribbon at the top and then click on Customize the Ribbon. Select New Tab at the bottom right and rename it. You can also create groups under your ribbon and give them names too. Then make sure the custom group you just made is selected and look at the left-hand side menu to select the comments you wish to display on your custom tab. You can move them as you see fit. You will now have access to your very own custom ribbon at the very top next to the Home tab. Number 14, customize the bottom status bar. So now we know we can customize the ribbon, but did you know that you can also customize the bottom bar status as well? If you right-click on it, you can see a list of options for what it can show. For example, in addition to word counts, you may want to always be able to see the character count as well. Next category, writing and editing. Tip number 15, how to sort a list in alphabetical order. If you have a list and you would like to sort it in alphabetical order, you can easily do this by selecting your list and then clicking on the Sort button of the Home ribbon. Number 16, move rows in a table. If you have a table in Word and want to reorganize it easily, you can use Alt, Shift, and the up arrow to move a row above, or Alt, Shift, and down arrow to move a row below. Number 17, the editor. Under the Review tab, click on Editor to have a summary of how you performed with your document in terms of how it's written and to get suggestions on how to improve its content. Number 18, Lorem Ipsum Generator. Sometimes you want a placeholder for future texts, but you don't have the content written yet. In this case, you can use the Lorem Ipsum generator. If you are unfamiliar with it, it's a dummy text in Latin used in design, graphic, and printing industries as a placeholder for previewing layouts and visual mockups. Word integrates a feature to generate this easily. If you type in equal Lorem and then open and close parentheses, it will generate some Lorem Ipsum text for you. And you can customize how much text you need. For example, if I put 4,2 into the parentheses, it will generate 4 paragraphs of 2 sentences each. And if you'd rather have a placeholder in English rather than in Latin, you can type in equal rand open and close parentheses. Number 19, the spike cut and paste. Spike lets you cut multiple sections of text or other content separately, so you can then put them all together simultaneously. The spike can be compared to the actual physical spike used in many restaurants. When you have paid your bill, it's stuck on the spike with other paid bills. The spike in Word works similarly. You can place multiple items to the spike and then paste all that content simultaneously. So I will highlight some text and then press Ctrl F3. What it does is, it cuts the selected text and adds it to the spike. If I only want to copy and not cut, then I'll hit Ctrl Z to undo the cut action. I'll repeat for each piece of content I want to copy. Ctrl F3 and then Ctrl Z if I want to only copy and not cut. Then when I'm ready to paste it all, I'll press Ctrl Shift F3 and then it will simply paste all the content from the spike simultaneously. Number 20, vertical text selection. Let's say I have a list of text with indentation or bullet points or with an odd format, and I want to copy only the text without the indentation. I can use the vertical text selection to do that. I'll hold the Alt key and then click and drag to select what I need. Number 21, add a screenshot feature. Sometimes you need to include screenshots in a document, which can be tedious. But Word has an integrated feature for that and it's really handy. You can find this by going in the Insert tab. Then when you click on Screenshot, this lets you automatically screenshot any other open window from another program and add that screenshot in one click. Just click the thumbnail of the window you want to screenshot and it will automatically do the rest for you. You can also click on Screen Clipping, which will minimize words and then let you click and drag to make a screenshot selection and add it in the same way. Number 22, Compare Documents feature. You can find this in the Review tab. Click on Compare, and then it will have you select the original and the revised documents, and then it shows you all the changes between the two documents, for example, what was added or changed. Number 23, Quick Parts. This feature allows you to save reusable content like text and images so you can easily access them and reuse them. For example, let's say I always want to have the company's legal disclaimer handy so I can add it to documents when required. To do so, just select the text you wish to save, go to the Insert tab, Quick Parts, and Save Selection to Quick Part Gallery. Give it a name and press OK. Next time you will need to insert this element again, you just have to go to the Insert tab, Quick Parts, and click on the component. Number 24, use formulas in Word. Did you know that you can use formulas in Microsoft Word? I have a table here with all these different numbers and I'd like to add it up to see the total. So I will place my cursor in the total cell, then go to the Layout tab on the right hand side and I'll hit the button Formula. This opens the formula dialog where I can type in a formula. And if you're familiar with Excel formulas, the same language will be used. But in this case, Word has deduced from my data that I might want to sum up the values together. So it already suggests the sum formula. So I'll click on OK to get the sum of my numbers. But this is not limited to the sum formula. I could use it for all types of formulas too. For example, the average formula or the if formula. Number 25, automated translation. Word integrates an option to translate content. You can find this under the Review tab and Translate. It then automatically detects the original language. You can change it if you wish to, and then you can choose which language you wish to translate to. Let's say French. We automatically get a translation, a word of caution that translation should always be double-checked, and then I can click on Insert to insert it into my document. I hope you found this video useful. Let us know in the comments if some of these features are new to you and if you think they can make your life easier, or if you are super proficient with Word and knew them all already. Don't hesitate to share this video with your colleagues so that they become as good as you are with Microsoft Word. If you wish to know more about document control and improve your skills in and around document control, join us in one of our courses, which allow to develop your skills and get your career on the right track. We have different courses, each one designed to accompany you throughout your career in document control. You can find the link in the description below.
We regularly release new content on document control, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel, to like this video, and to hit the notification bell to be notified of any useful new content.